Welcome to Savvy IT Solutions. Now we are discussing about control structures in programming in C. Okay, this is the one of the important concept in programming in any programming language, not programming in C, in any one of the programming language. This is the heart of the programming language. So now we are moving to the next slide. Okay, so here we are discussing about why control structures, introduction to control structures and types of control structures. We need to discuss these three topics in this video. Okay, so now why control structures? This is one of the important part. Skipping from statement to statement, group of statements run or execute repeatedly, block or continuing a block of statements. These are the main reasons control structures are introduced. So I will tell you briefly in one by one. So the program, the traditional programming is executed in sequential way. Okay, so we need to skipping from, let us assume these are the statement numbers 3 to 5 directly. It is not possible in sequential way. So what we are doing is, if we need to check some check conditions and we need to skip those statements accordingly. So to solve the problem of skipping from statement to statement, this is not happened previously, but now we need to do it with the help of control structures. The second one is group of statements run repeatedly. Okay, three statements run 10 times is olden days. What we are doing is first three, next three, next three, like we are giving it. Same statement we execute repeatedly with the help of. For in control structures, it reduces the problem. We write only three statements and those three statements run repeatedly with the help of control structures. Next one is block or continuing a block of statements. So let us assume these are the block statements. Okay, in between what are the statements we are writing, those are belongs to that particular block. So we need to come out or continuing again from starting with the help of control structures. This is also not happened in previously. To overcome these two problems, the problems are very clear that skipping from statement to statement, group of statements run or execute repeatedly, block or continuing a block of statements. These cannot be happened in sequential execution. Now we are moving into what is control structures. Control structures are just a way to specify flow of control in programs. Any algorithm or program can be more clear and understood if they use self-contained modules called as logic or control structures. It basically analyzes and chooses in which direction a program flows based on certain parameters or conditions. Programs written in procedural languages, the most common kind, are like recipes having lists of ingredients and step-by-step instructions for using them. The three basic control structures in virtually every procedural language are sequence, combine the liquid ingredients, and next add the dry ones. Conditionally, if the tomatoes are fresh, then simmer them, but if cannot, skip this step. Iterative, beat the egg whites until they form soft peaks. So sequence, conditional, and iterative. These are the major parts in control structures. Now I am telling you types of control structures. Actually, the control are classified into three types. One is conditional control structure, loop control structure, and unconditional control structures. The first problem, skipping from statement to statement by solving conditional control structures, group of statements run repeatedly to solve with loop control structures, and breaking or terminating a block of statements with the help of unconditional control structures. Again, these conditional control structures are classified into two types. One is decision making or branching. Second one is selection based. Okay. So again, this decision making is classified into four things. One is simple if else, nested if else, and else if ladder. Selection based, only one thing, that is switch. Okay. Now coming to the loop control structures, again these loop control structures are divided into two types. One is infinite loops and second one is finite loops. These infinite loops are again classified into two things. One is while and second one is do while, and infinite loop is for. Okay. Coming to the unconditional control structures, we have break, continue and go to. So this is what exactly the control structures contains. This is the one of the important concept in any one of the programming languages. If you understand control structures very properly, you can write the maximum programs very easily. Okay. And the applications, logic building, everything should be depending upon this control structures. So we covered almost all 50 to 80 programs in this section to understand the basic concepts of control structures. Okay. We are not at all delaying or dragging. We will explain each and every part very clearly and very maturely so that you can better understand the concepts. Okay. Our goal is to explain simple if else, nested else if, switch, while, do while, for, break, continue, go to, with n number of examples. So we need to explain the syntax of each and every part. At the same time, we are also giving the flow control, how it works in a flow chart. Finally, we are taking n number of examples to compute them. Okay. At the same time, we are also doing in practically. So this is what exactly we are making into the goal. In the next video onwards, we are discussing about decision making or branching. Under this, first is simple if, and simultaneously one practical session, if else and practical section, nested if else with practical section, else if ladder with practical section. Simultaneously we are completing all the things. Okay. So this is one of the important concept. If you continuously watching it, it helps you a better way. Okay. If you are missing it, ultimately you need to watch more times to understand. Okay. So that is why I am telling you. So again, I am over you, recap the story. So why control structures? That is one of the important topic. So the first one is, it is not happened before introducing control structures. One is skipping from statement to statement. Second one is group of statements run repeatedly. And the third point is break or terminating or continuing a block of statement. This is not happened in before control structures. After introducing the control structures, these three problems can be resolved with the help of control structures. Under this, now the control structures is classified into three types. One is conditional control structures, loop control structures, and unconditional control structures. Now, again, the problem of skipping from statement to statement can be solved with the help of conditional control structures. Group of statements run repeatedly with the help of loop control structures. And terminating or continuing a block of statements with the help of unconditional control structures. Okay. Again, this conditional control structures is classified into two types. One is decision making or branching, and the second one is selection based. Okay. And loop control structures are again classified into two types. One is infinite loops and second one is finite loops. Okay. Hope you understand the concept, and in the next series of videos will help you a better understanding of control structures in detail. Thank you.